Good evening, you darling Thylacines, and welcome to RetroTech Comms. I am your host, Jacob of RetroTech, and today we are playing Ty the Tasmanian Tiger. I am here with...
Von Red 1.
Cobra Clan 13.
And I am here with...
Von Red 1.
And...
Cobra Clan 13.
And we are going to do... Beyond the Black Stump.
I actually don't remember this level that much.
Really?
The one with all the fire. Well, there
you go. Oh.
Yep.
It's pretty much like kind of like Snow Warriors. Okay, what's with these portals?
Don't know.
They're just
there. Ty, this is so dreadful. You are the most irresponsible mother in the world!
Please understand.
Granted, you didn't have any control over the avalanche, the pond getting dried up, and the bushfire, but... Are your children going to get kidnapped next? Goodness gracious. No. Well, there's one picture frame I just collected. Well...
Well,
good job.
I did that to the rainbow scale, and now I just did it to that. Okay, whatever. We'll just roll with it. So this is Beyond the Black Stump. This is another big level. A lot of these levels are big levels. But this level is one of the first ones that can get really, really confusing. But anyway, you're going to need your Frosty Ring for this level because just the amount of stuff you're going to be doing.
Mega Ring.
I didn't really put that much respect on the Mega Ring in my playthrough. I used it a few times.
I like it. I do
it. I like it.
It's probably because it looks like a shuriken.
So yeah, we're going to be finding children throughout this entire level.
Wait, why? I feel like you found children before somewhere else. Oh wait, this entire game.
Yeah, Snow worries. I have plenty of worries.
Horrible, mom. 3 out of 10. Like, how do you have that much children?
Koalas. Okay. I don't know. I've heard from some sources that she's actually a school teacher, and those aren't actually her children. But I don't know.
I don't know.
I never confirmed it. So I don't know. Maybe I'll rock a wiki later. Alright, this log always confused me because I would usually just jump across it, but you can actually rotate it by... Oh, that's a flame ring. You can actually rotate it by hitting it with any of the boomerangs.
Here I am.
I'm aware that you are there.
Here I am. Those fruits just like, he's too tough for us. That's because you just run up to him and try to beat him with your fist.
There's a fun fact that you can actually do with the hitboxes, which I'm going to try and attempt to do now. If you get the frills close enough, if you get the frills close enough to you, come on. Come on. Stop punching me. You can actually make a makeshift platform off the top of their heads, and what you can do with that is stop moving!
Oh,
that's cool.
I'm trying to get on top of that.
Yeah, there we go!
Oh!
That is
my god.
That is an exploit you can do.
I did it.
And now you die.
They didn't do anything wrong, though.
So yeah, that is a little exploit that you can do, the little makeshift platform from the frill heads. But anyway, how you're supposed to do this is to go inside of this disgusting thing, get launched over to here, collect this child, then go into this one, get launched over to there, and that's how you're supposed to get it.
Just go get disposable child number 4, and then go get the,
Wow.
I mean...
She has 8, she can have some.
Whoa!
I mean, she's not wrong.
Stop!
She's not wrong.
Oh my god, Mega Ring! The Mega Ring is great.
I love the Mega Ring. I like it. It's probably because it was like a shuriken.
Whoa.
Jesus, he jumped all the way over it.
No, what happened was I jumped on it, and then the physics just flung me.
Okay.
Oh, this isn't going to be good.
Oh, my God.
Instantly consumed. And we got launched over to here.
One day it's just like, you know, I'm not going to spit you out. You're just going to stay here with
me.
And
we just get launched over here.
Yeehaw!
Then we get launched
over here. Tools of destruction was okay. How'd you get up there?
Fire!
I don't know. The power of adrenaline.
Oh, I was just running in place.
They're froze. They're not.
He's doing the shuffle.
Running Man challenge looks good.
I'm with you. Where's the Omega Ring? Oh, wait. No, this is the wrong game.
Wrong game.
That literally makes the Multi Ring and Omega Ring obsolete at the same time.
Oh, the last ring with the Earth Stone.
That's when things just get ridiculous in that game.
Nothing beats the Mega Stone with the Earth Stones. That's just fantastic. Good job, Jacob. Hey, at least the children in one place.
Yep.
And then she's going to lose again.
Yep. Alright. Mm-hmm. Tie 4. And find the children again.
They're all going.
No, you seriously do.
Oh, God.
They're all adults.
Well, they're not really the children per se. You just have to find koalas. Just random.
They should call Child Protective Services on her.
Well, they're not technically Boonie and Marie and all of the other koalas we're seeing now.
Stop losing your children.
They're not the children, though. They're just random koalas. Well,
stop losing the people you're responsible for.
She's not responsible for all of the koalas in the world.
Yes,
people,
she
like
is.
Her, people like her, why Harambe happened.
I would just like to remind everyone that the US of A is currently in its 6th month of mourning the death of a gorilla.
People are still mad about it.
Harambe didn't deserve
to
die.
He died for our sins.
Stop. Harambe is bae.
Oh my God.
It's time to stop.
It is time to stop.
It's never time to stop for an uncaused death.
You're not wrong, but at the same time.
Harambe for president.
No.
So we're going to have a court for a president.
We're
okay.
We're not talking politics right now. Stop.
I'm
going to stop.
I'm going to stop the politics right there.
I'm going to stop. Yes.
Harambe for Canada.
Canada.
I respect them more.
Home of the moose and maple syrup.
I'm gonna have some good Canadian syrup. With some lumberjack pancakes.
Or the Publix.
I don't put respect on Publix.
They don't call them pancakes. Oh. Well, maybe they call
them pancakes. Who does put respect on Publix?
Don't we call them, like, flapjacks or something?
There are several places... Oh, Boonie. There are several places that call them flapjacks. That's mainly a northern-ish sort of... Yes, that's a northernism for it.
My mom just now realized what they were called pancakes, like, 2 years ago. I was like, are you serious?
Really?
Yeah, she was like... Well, I don't know, she just realized, she was just like, I just thought about it. Like, I know why it's called this exactly now. I'm like, please tell me you're joking. I don't know if she was or not. I hope she was joking.
And she probably had, it's probably one of those things that she always knew but never actually thought of.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is a little speedrun tactics.
Yes, speedrun tactics.
It is. Now, I technically would have... This would have been much faster and actually would have been a shortcut had I not died earlier. But anyway, that's called a death warp. I didn't activate any of the dunnies, so I can just kill myself and then instantly warp there for a speedrun.
You can just kill yourself and it's instantly warped. I wish real life worked that way.
Oh my God! Don't worry, sir. When we get the program into the body, we can just kill ourselves and reboot.
You're not wrong.
Pausing the episode. Before we go back, I'd just like to point out that you see, like, there's like a stick figure like rotating
inside
the Thunder Egg.
Good job,
you see
Chrome.
That? It's like a stick figure like rotating in perpetual doom. Oh, that's hilarious.
Stuck.
Right. Oh, we can just do this now.
Oh, you do see him again.
Here.
This guy.
No.
This guy, okay, you are racing in a bushfire right now. What's wrong with you?
Nope, bushfire is in here. It's over there.
You know what? This is actually my least favorite level now that I think about it. This part of the level was annoying to me. Not yeah. this race, this part of the level.
Yeah, I know.
Oh.
I forgot about that.
You know, I think I always hit this level so much that I blocked it out of my memory because I don't remember this. I remember it, but I don't remember it, if that makes sense.
It wasn't fun. Like, this part of it. The first part's cool, but this part.
No, it's hot because of the fire.
Ha!
Huh. Fire!
Oh, yeah, the ice phases are going to stop me. Yep. There we go. God.
I don't remember how the ice phases, but I was racing last night.
It's actually working in your favor now.
I also would like to point out that he is keeping his momentum even though he is moving on a horizontal plane.
Ha! Life hack. It sucks that I'm like, okay, I'm on my feet right now, and I'm still running faster than you, skating. Mm-hmm.
You suck, son. Get skills.
Get good.
Get wrecked, scrub. Yeah, boy. I don't know. Mm-hmm. Yes, I won. I regret nothing.
Oh my god.
Well, I saved myself, though. The cutscene saved me.
With the cutscene and trigger.
That would have been hilarious. Alright, there we go, and that's Time Attack, or whatever that is. What is it called? Wombat Rematch. Yeah,
that was the fifth rematch.
That wasn't a rematch. That was nothing.
Scars needs to stop.
No, I'm gonna keep racing you, bro, until I beat you. Oh, the useless power-up.
I didn't even touch this one, like, over here. I was like, you know what? I'll use rings.
Yeah, Mega Rings work great.
I appreciate them putting something like that in the game, but like...
That's impractical.
Yeah. Never used it.
Did they extend time on it?
No, it's always been this long. There we are.
Oh. Wow.
What?
I didn't know it lasted that long.
Mm-hmm.
It's probably because I really go for
it. It's so situational, though. It's just like nobody cares. Yeah, it's really interesting. Like, Taiwan is great, but there's a lot of situational stuff in it.
Yep.
Like situational power-ups, situational boomerangs,
yep.
Situational everything. Booney!
He heard you were collecting them. Wait a minute, that's my job. So it is. Can you go and grab the little tot before he gets himself into trouble, Ty?
Fate of the world, you got someone stealing something that I need to save the world.
Alright, so we need to find Booney.
Some bad shit happened to him. Okay, Frill.
Alright, Booney, where are you? Yeah, there's really nothing much to say about this. Oh, here he is. Hey, Booney. Oh, you got a Thunder Egg for me? Booney, where are you going? Booney, come here. Booney.
Nah, run, man. You know.
Booney.
Run, boy, run.
You trying to ring him? Why are you trying to ring a little kid, man?
Booney, stop.
Run. Oh, my God, that spider.
Well, at least I stopped him quickly.
You're getting bitten to shreds in the cutscene.
Okay, the reason why I dislike Booney is because this little brat runs away from you. It's like he actively knows that you're looking for the Thunder Eggs, and then he withholds it from you and runs away from you. Fate of the world!
I'm a kid, though.
I'm a kid and shiny.
You mean whatever.
The Thunder Jet?
What?
Computer, internet, mobile phones, that drives it mad.
Yes, it does. It drives me mad, Marty.
As we're playing on PC.
Anyway. Oh, look, another situational power up. I'll use it anyway. Oh, I said I'll use it anyway. Give me that. Did this power up ever return?
No, it didn't. I think they realized how impractical it was. The bunions pretty much replaced this.
Yeah.
Yeah. This was the precursor to the bunyips.
What is that technically a bunyip right there?
It is a bunyip. This is like the spiritual form of a bunyip. Like, that's always confused me, like the whole term bunyip, because bunyip refers to like this race of beings in another dimension.
But
bunyip also refers to mechs and machines. So I was always confused. I like this multi-purpose word. Oh, that is an unfortunate camera angle.
I got something. You can't tell what it was, but I got something.
It was a thunder egg. Alright, so now through this literal hole in the wall are two more frills. Really annoying frills. I can't jump up there, but anyway, I'll just get this fourth bunyip. Bilby, excuse me! Yep, come on. And we get the golden cog. Yes. Oh, come on, really?
Yeah.
Fine, I'll do it the... I'm going to do this my way.
No, you won't.
Yes, I am.
I don't want you over there.
Okay, apparently that was changed because... I
tried the same thing last night.
Apparently that was changed because you were supposed to be able to do that. Fine. I'll go back the normal way.
Do it the hard way. It's like London, it's the hard way.
What?
I don't know. I'm still mad at Booney.
Yeah.
He's like a kickball. I'll kick him.
Wow. That's a child, Kevon. No,
that's a kickball.
That's a child.
It's a kickball that steals Thunder Race.
Alright, and the last Bilby. Right there. Okay, and now we get to the most long and drawn out part of the level. The gondolas. Oh, hello, Ranger Ken.
What's him gonna do?
I will, you're gonna do it.
Wow. Ranger Ken be like. Why can't you do it, Ranger Ken? I mean, you're a ranger.
I got an overview, mile and everything. I can't do it myself. That requires too much effort.
NPCs.
Well, that sounds like it's your fault, not mine.
Listen here, Sonny boy.
Alright, Ken has never said Sonny boy.
That's something you would say, though.
That's something you would say.
It is something you say.
I don't think Sonny boy is the thing that Australians say, actually.
He'd still say it.
He'd say it because he's Ken. Anyone named Ken would say something like that. G'day, Ty. That's what it is, mate.
Mm.
His arms are longer than Ty's Zoomerang range.
Wow.
Like, jeez.
I just imagined, like, a Garry's Mod arm stretch of Ranger Ken.
Oh, my God.
Oh, there's another box here, if you're interested in that.
Boxing.
Right.
What? Boxes.
What is wrong with you?
Whatever.
Alright, so now on to the gondola, which is...
This part was boring.
This is so boring, and I guess Chrome decided to ignore my request to speed these things up. Like, can we please speed these things up?
Or just put a flower there that launches you up there instead of having to ride this.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Luckily, I had the Kaboomerang at this point, so like...
Alright, so the whole point of this... The whole point of this is to... ride the gondolas and... He's trying to throw something at me. I missed horribly.
Those were annoying.
Yeah, we just have to take out the frills on top of these towers, and you know what? Just no commentary. We're fast forwarding through this. It's so slow.
Patience, sir. Greatness awaits.
Yeah. Sure. Thanks. Okay. We finally made it up to the top after 84 years.
I grew a beard in the time it took me to get up there.
I've grown a full Dumbledore. Alright, so instead of going back, what I'm going to do is head down here. There are several opals to collect and...
Well, there's a cog.
Well, yeah, there's one of them. I'm just going to launch myself up here. That was terrible.
Look at me glide down. Yep.
Okay, so anyway... there are several opals to get on the way down here, and I don't want to ride those gondolas again for the 17 quintillionth time. So what we are going to do is miss a opal. And we're going to do this area next. Now I have to launch myself back up there.
3, 2,
get punched by Thanos. You get uppercut.
Jesus.
Oh, there's one up there. Curses.
Get uppercut. I thought I saw it, but I thought I was just seeing things.
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, man. Free fall. Oh!
My spike. My scapula.
My spike. Wait a minute, did I miss one of them over here?
You missed another one.
It was, well, yeah. I don't know which level it was on.
Though. Go up, just go all the way up and...
Yep, just...
Back up we go. Because I'm bad at video games.
Higher.
No. No, I was here. I was like...
There.
Oh, there it is. That little green spot. Sick. My spine.
All right. There's a whole pie in here, so we're good.
Oh yeah, if you break your back, just eat a pie, and you'll be good.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Biblical logic. I mean, that's what happened last week to me. The person outside agrees.
And jumping a corpse literally just to make you all better.
Alrighty. And are there any more stuff? This is there.
Not in the air.
What did I land on?
I hit air and it hurt. What in the world was that?
I don't know what's happening.
All right, Chrome.
Chrome Senpai, please.
Keep doing it.
I can't remember if there's anything back here.
I don't believe so. I don't even remember this part of the level.
Invisible wall. I got this part, I was like, oh god, please don't be a huge open area, and it wasn't, luckily. Yeah. I boxed you off.
Yeah, they boxed you off with... It's like, it looks like you could explore all this. No, there's an invisible wall.
That scared me at first, because I was already like getting tired of this level. I was like, oh no.
Snow Worries is bad. Well, I don't
Snow Worries isn't that bad.
I love Snow Worries.
Alright, there is a golden cog in that snow mound. It is right here at the base of this giant rock face.
Of death. And then there's another one right here.
Just
casually placed right here.
Yep.
And that's like, the final one. You torture you enough. Here you go.
Well, let's see. We need to place one more.
Right there.
Right there. Forget it.
You're on track with the opals because there's only 5 that we need. Or wait. My bad.
He's close.
15.
Yep.
Should be like...
Alright, and let's go ahead and do another...
This
Ranger
was interesting, because like, if you use the right stick, the controls are good. If you use the left stick, they're inverted. So I had to hold the controller like this.
Alright, if I can position this correctly.
Oh, wow.
Yep, alright. So how was your day, gentlemen?
Good. Had a really good sandwich today. The new Cuban place in Auburndale was
nice.
Pretty good.
Yeah,
Pretty good.
The weather was really nice out this morning, so I went for a jog, and that was pleasant.
I slept.
The weather was nice, so I stayed inside to play video games.
Yep. That sounds about right.
You know, there was a meter that striked down, but so I stayed inside to play video games.
There's a meteor that struck down.
Oh.
How did you slip through?
He's swift.
Oh, great. Now I have to do this normally. Oh, come on.
Check the other side.
What are you doing, Ken?
I'm just going to sit here and survey the area because, I've got to protect everything by just watching it.
He's the original Smokey the Bear.
I don't know how he slipped through that. That was really annoying. Bruh!
How a snowball... Okay, so you have that turret right there, but you don't use it for your... Can't you make it automated?
No, it requires effort. I'm not doing that. I'm going to let you do it instead. I'll give you a thunder ray, so stop whining
about it. Bruh!
Hey, why are you missing? I'm paying you for a reason.
If Kid was like that, oh my god. Entitled.
I don't know why I'm missing them. Because honestly, this is a pathetically easy
because
level.
Because it's not Stark Tech.
Anyway, there we go.
What?
You put a Stark technology to Australian outdated...
Hey man, it doesn't matter where it's from, man. Superior tech.
But everything costs like 50% more in Australia.
Well, it should be even 50% better then.
What?
Ladies and gentlemen, bomber.
What kind of logic is that?
What logic?
Bleeding edge logic.
Stop.
Keep going. As a matter of fact.
Oh, no. I'm not doing this. No. Okay, so now we have to do the long... Okay. Okay, so as I was saying, we have to now do the long, arduous task of climbing back up the mountain. That's by climbing, I mean launching ourselves through a flower.
A corpse lily. That stinks. And Titus jumps right in like, yeah, man, yeah. Hardcore.
Oh, yeah, this is happening.
Shouldn't the altitude, like, hurt his ears right now? Well, not hurt his ears, but might make him tired.
Oh, yeah, the rapid altitude change should, make his ears pop horribly. Okay, unfortunately, the opal machine... Oh, wait, no, it's at the beginning of the level, duh. I don't have to worry about that. So now we have to go back down the side of the mountain.
You know what the funny part about it? Going down it this way is actually faster than doing it normal.
Yeah.
It is.
Ah, Mega Ring, man. That doesn't defy the laws of physics at all. It's like Cap Shield.
Koala technology.
The more you realize the Mega Rings are Cap Shield.
So, see, they do have Stark technology, so what's your excuse for the turn again?
What are we talking about?
You just said, notice how the Mega Rings are more or less Cap Shield. So that's proof that you have Stark technology.
I was about to say the Cap Shield isn't Stark tech, then I was dying to think about it.
Let's say that.
Wait, is it?
Yeah, it's his dad.
It is. His dad made it. Howard Stark.
Oh, okay.
It's outdated Stark tech, but it's still better than anything Stark can make because it always whoops Stark, but that's a different topic.
Well, I wouldn't know.
Jacob, well, I wouldn't know.
It's vibranium, so I see what your point is.
You see what my point is.
It's vibranium.
Triggered.
It's vibranium. Though.
Yeah, it's good vibranium.
It's vibranium, so I don't see your point.
You should see my point because it's vibranium.
You're trying to say you can't make anything better.
You can't make better stuff.
Then vibranium.
I also like how.
No, not Ranger then Ken. Cap Shield, yeah, not the vibranium.
He needs the vibranium to do that.
I like how Ranger Ken warps between areas.
Because Ranger Ken is Ranger Ken, mate. We could have just warped out of the ways of the frills and.
Okay, there we go. I killed myself. Oh, good, I'm down here, which means I can go over here.
How's the snow and fire in the same place, though? It makes no sense, dude.
It's a song of fire and ice.
Did you just?
Yes, I just.
Did you just?
Yes, I just.
Okay.
All right, we're done. Yay. That's Beyond the Black Stump. We're done. Okay.
And that's the second.
And now for the worst level of all.
Oh,
yeah, man. We're going to get to that next episode. All right. This is Jacob of RetroTech.
Wandered One.
Cobra Clan 13.
Signing off in the next episode. I don't want to, but we have to anyway. We are going to move on to Rex Marks the Spot.
Shipwrecks times five.
Bye!